Hey folks, it's Pete Thorne. Welcome to my home studio. I actually made this video in between my home here and my other studio space. I just wanted some variety. Why not? This is my video for the Moor Radar. Terrific little pedal. The main thing this does is speaker simulation. It's also got high quality power amp sims in it, as well as some EQ options. Mainly in this video, I'm going to focus on the speaker simulation and the impulse response hosting capability of this unit. You guys know I'm a really big fan of using tube amps with load boxes and then IRs for speaker simulation. These types of setups allow me to use my big powerful up to 100 watt tube amps in an environment even like this, and I can record with them and do it even through headphones and get some great quality tones that are basically indistinguishable from tones that would be like normally considered something you would do in a recording studio with microphones and preamps and stuff like that. So it's a really, really cool technology that allows you to use your tube amps in just about any environment and get some great tones. So normally I would add the speaker simulation in my computer, in Logic, that's my DAW. I would load it up on a plugin in Logic and away we go. But there's obviously advantages to hosting IRs or the speaker simulation being in something like this. It's super small, you can take it with you. So if you wanna do the IR load box thing and do it live, this is kind of the way to go. You don't have to haul around your computer and you can just host the IRs with something like this. And in addition to that, you could even move to using just a pedalboard-based guitar rig. Moor makes a bunch of little preamp pedals that you can then plug into this and do the power amp, EQ, and speaker simulation in this device. You can also find these types of units from a whole bunch of different companies. This is the Revival Drive from Origin Effects. This is basically a really high-quality guitar preamp in a pedal. They bill it as an overdrive pedal, but it really is like a preamp. So in this video, in a little bit, you're going to see me plug this into this, and I'll be hosting some Celestion impulse responses in the Moor that I loaded via their software app. And, I got some great tones just using this and this together. Really cool. So the options are many, and the advantages are many as well, using something like this to host your impulse responses. Now, also consider that when you're hosting the IRs in your DAW, you know, Pro Tools, Cubase, Logic, whatever you use, you're going to be listening to the return of Pro Tools or the return of Logic, since you're hosting it on the input strip or on the channel within your DAW. The latency is always going to be a little bit greater because of that. You have a little bit more latency. With this guy, it's down to sub 2 milliseconds latency. So when I'm running this into this and then plugging out into, say, a powered speaker or even into my recording interface, but just listening to the input of my recording interface, not listening through Logic or the DAW, I've got sub 2 milliseconds of latency, which is really, really low. So that's another advantage. Plus, it's just really easy. I mean, you can just load up some programs in here and just turn this knob. You know, I want my Greenback 412, I want my V30 412, I want my Openback 212, and you just turn that, you know, something tactile and easy about it, just being able to turn that knob and get to all your different sounds really easily. You might have some questions about whether or not a unit like this can sound as good, right? About whether or not hosting an IR in here sounds the same as if you were to host it in the computer. I'm also going to demonstrate that in this video and show you that yes, it essentially sounds exactly the same hosting the impulse response in here or within a plugin in Logic. The one thing that will change, just observance of total transparency, let's say. Basically, units like this, they tend to truncate the IR. So they're going to cut off the tail of the IR. This guy is pretty good. It's at about 23 milliseconds. That's plenty long enough for a great close mic'd guitar speaker cabinet sound. 23 milliseconds is just fine. You're just not going to be able to put room mic type IRs in here or something like that. It's going to chop off the tail at 23 milliseconds. You're not going to be able to take advantage of that. But that's a limitation that most units like this have. They'll all truncate somewhere 18 to 20 something milliseconds, generally speaking. So this one's actually pretty darn good. And like I say, you're not going to notice basically any difference when you're doing a close mic'd cabinet IR, hosting it in here or in the computer. And I will demonstrate that in a little bit in the video here. Another great use for something like this is actually hosting acoustic IRs. This is kind of a thing that maybe a lot of people haven't checked out, but there's a few companies out there in the market. One of them I just checked out yesterday was these IRs from Three Sigma. They're making acoustic IRs. So what that is they somehow make an impulse response of the body of an acoustic guitar. And basically what that translates to is you can plug in, say, a transducer micropiezo equipped acoustic guitar that normally has that kind of synthetic or sort of quacky quasi acoustic sound, but it's never quite awesome, into a unit like this. Host an acoustic IR in here, and you can really get a lot closer to a mic'd up acoustic sound. Sounds like an acoustic guitar in the studio with a nice microphone on it. So I'm actually going to demonstrate that a little later in the video as well. In the song at the beginning of the video, I mainly used Celestion IRs that I put into the Moore Radar using their software app. You know, I like using my own IRs. I know the ones I like and the speaker simulation that I like, and it's sort of it's a personal thing. It's like using the microphone and the preamp you like on the speaker you like in the right place. You know, so this one comes loaded with a whole bunch of IRs. I am going to demonstrate one of those for you, which is of a Fender Tweed Deluxe, and I thought it sounded just great. But mostly in this video, I loaded this one up with IRs I'm really familiar with. I wanted to see whether or not they sounded good in the radar. Indeed, they did, and so you're going to see mostly that in this video. Okay, well, let's get on to some sound examples. I want to solo some of the tracks from the song at the beginning of the video outside of the mix so you can clearly hear some different IRs in the Moore Radar. And then we're going to get on to those other sound examples I mentioned as well. Okay, here we go. It's the Moore Radar. So I did a stereo hard pan pair of kind of heavy, dirty rhythm guitars in the song at the beginning of the video, and I wanted to have some options to use so that I could, you know, use some different cabinet impulse responses on the different hard pan tracks. So in the Moore, using their application, I loaded up a few different 412s and just stored them as presets. So in user slot number one, I've got a G12M Greenback in a 412 cabinet. These are all Celestion IRs. In user slot 2, I got a Neo Creamback, and in user slot 3, I've got a V30 in a 412. And these are the IRs that Celestion sells on their site as Celestion All mixes. So they're mic mixes where you're blending a 57 and a 421 and a Royer 121 all into one impulse response and getting a really nice fat and detailed blended impulse response. So it's just really nice to be able to just turn this knob and you can easily select different impulse responses, audition different ones, and then when you're going to cut different tracks, you can easily just, you know, change an IR like super quick. So here's the Greenbacks first. Okay, let's check out the Neo Creambacks. And V30s. We'll be right back. So just for a second, I wanted to touch on what I think is a really, really cool use for something like the radar. You know, we've covered how you can use it for recording into a DAW. We've covered how, you know, you could use it as a reamp solution into a big PA system live. But don't discount the fact that you can actually use it in a setting like this, just at home and at a really low volume, and you don't actually even need a computer. So to demonstrate this, I'm not recording in Logic. I'm simply, you're going to hear the guitar coming through the same microphone that's capturing my voice right now. And so I've got my Sur guitar here plugged into that Comet amp, which is, you know, normally that's a ripping loud amp. It's about 50 watts. And I've got it cranked up on 7 or so right now. And it's running into the Sur reactive load. I'm coming quarter inch out of the reactive load into the little radar pedal here. And I'm coming out of the radar right now into my recording interface, but I'm not recording in Logic. I'm just playing through the UA console interface, which is like sort of the input of my computer. And I'm adding a little bit of reverb and delay just for some fun using some plugins. And then the sound's going right to my studio monitors. Really, really low latency. And, you know, once again, I'm not recording in Logic, and you're just gonna hear the sound coming through the same microphone as my voice. Because the point is, with this demonstration, that you don't need a DAW. You don't need to know how to use Logic. You don't need any of that stuff. I could literally be taking the output out of the radar right now and plugging it right into any kind of powered monitor, like a powered studio monitor, just quarter inch right out into that monitor, or, you know, just a little powered speaker of some sort, or a big powered speaker, something from JBL or QSC or something like that. But you can turn the volume way down and get the volume like a raging 50 watt amp or whatever, even in an environment like this, at a really, you know, nice reduced level. I miss playing through that Comet. I haven't used it for a long time. It sounds really, really good. But I'm playing it at you know, it's just super low volume. I'm going to switch to a Greenback IR here just for fun. So the radar can really help you turn you know, a raging tube amp into a low volume, really cool home practice solution. All you'd really need to do is add a nice load box and some sort of powered speaker system. You could even do this through headphones, just add a little headphone amp and play through some phones. I'm adding a little bit of effects here in UA console, which is really fun, just a delay and plate reverb. But if you want to, you could use some effects pedals to do that. You could come out of the output of the radar, run into a little delay and reverb or something like that, blend it into the sound, and then, like I say, be listening through a little headphone amp or something like that, or just a powered speaker of some sort. Really, really cool. Alrighty, thanks for watching my video on the Moore Radar. Super high quality speaker simulation, power amp sims, and EQ, all in a really affordable little pedal. This thing can really open up a world of possibilities if you need some high quality speaker simulation in a super portable format. I hope I was able to answer any questions you might have on it. Go check it out further at the Moore website. It's there on your screen. And hey, I'm Pete Thorne. Please hit subscribe if you haven't. Come back and see me for more videos very soon. Alright, take care.